Hello everyone, myself Shivangi Desai, your instructor for the video series of Data Mining and Business Intelligence. Today's our topic is Data Pre-Processing. So let's get started. Well, the first question is, why to pre-process data? Well, data have quality if they satisfy the requirements of the intended use. There are many factors comprising data quality, including accuracy, completeness, consistency, timeliness, believability, and interpretability. Imagine that you are a manager at an electronics store and you have been charged with analyzing the company's data with respect to your branch sales. Now you immediately set out to perform this task. You carefully inspect the company's database and data warehouse, identifying and selecting the attributes or dimensions. Say for example, item, price, and unit sold, and etc. This needs to be included in your analysis. During the process, you notice that several of the attributes for various tuples have no recorded values. For your analysis, you would like to include information as to whether each item purchased was advertised as on sale, yet you discover that this information has not been recorded. Furthermore, users of your database system have reported errors, unusual values, and inconsistencies in the data recorded for some transactions. In other words, the data you wish to analyze by data mining techniques are incomplete, inaccurate, or noisy and inconsistent. This scenario illustrates three of the elements defining data quality, that are accuracy, completeness, and consistency. Well, accuracy refers to whether the data values stored for an object are the correct value. In order for data to be accurate, the data value must be the right value and must be represented in a consistent and unambiguous form. Completeness refers to an indication of whether or not all the data necessary to meet the current and future business information demand are available in the data resources. And last, that is consistency. Any data written to the database must be valid according to all defined rules. That is all about consistency. Inaccurate, incomplete, and inconsistent data are common properties of large real-world databases and data warehouses. There are many possible reasons for inaccurate data. The data collection instruments used may be faulty. There may have been human or computer errors occurring at data entry. Users may purposely submit incorrect data values for mandatory fields when they do not wish to submit personal information. Well, this is known as disguised missing data. Errors in data transmission can also occur. There may be technology limitations such as limited buffer size for coordinating synchronized data transfer and consumption. Incorrect data may also result from inconsistencies in naming conventions or data codes or inconsistent formats for input field. Duplicate tuples also require data cleaning. Incomplete data can occur for a number of reasons. Attributes of interest may not always be available, such as customer information for sales transaction data. Other data may not be included simply because they were not considered important at the time of entry. Relevant data may not be recorded due to misunderstanding or because of equipment malfunctions. Data that were inconsistent with other recorded data may have been deleted. Furthermore, the recording of the data history or modification may have been overlooked. Missing data, particularly for tuples with missing values for some attributes, may need to be inferred. Recall the data quality depends on the intended use of the data. Two different users may have very different assessment of the quality of a given database. For example, a marketing analyst may need to access the database mentioned before for a list of customer addresses. Some of the addresses are outdated or incorrect, yet overall 80% of the addresses are accurate. The marketing analyst considered this to be a large customer database for target marketing purpose and is pleased with the database accuracy. Although as sales manager, you found that the data is inaccurate. Timeliness also affects data quality. Timeliness refers to the time expectation for accessibility and availability of information. Timeliness can be measured as the time between when information is expected and when it is readily available for use. Two other factors affecting data quality are believability and interpretability. Believability reflects how much the data are trusted by users, while interpretability reflects how easy the data are understood. Suppose that a database at one point had several errors, all of which have since been corrected. The past errors, however, had caused many problems for sales department users, and that is why they no longer trust the data. The data also use many accounting codes, which the sales department does not know how to interpret. Even though the database is now accurate, complete, consistent, and timely, sales department users may regard it as of low quality due to poor believability and interpretability. Now let's discuss the tasks that are involved in data pre-processing. As you can see in this figure, the major steps involved in data pre-processing are data cleaning, data integration, data reduction, and data transformation. So let's discuss data cleaning in detail. Data cleaning routines work to clean the data by filling in missing values, smoothing out the noisy data, or identifying or removing outliers, as well as resolving the inconsistencies. If users believe the data are dirty, they are unlikely to trust the results of any data mining that has been applied. Furthermore, dirty data can cause confusion for the mining procedure, resulting in unreliable output. Although most mining routines have some procedures for dealing with incomplete or noisy data, they are not always robust. Instead, they may concentrate on avoiding overfitting the data to the function being modeled. Therefore, a useful pre-processing step is to run your data through some data cleaning routines. Now let's discuss data integration. Let's take an example. Suppose that you would like to include data from multiple sources in your analysis. This would involve integrating multiple databases, data cubes, or files. Yet, some attributes representing a given concept may have different names in different databases, which cause inconsistencies and redundancies. For example, the attribute for customer identification may be referred to as customer ID in one data store and cust ID in another. Having a large amount of redundant data may slow down or confuse the knowledge discovery process. Clearly, in addition to data cleaning, steps must be taken to help avoid redundancies during data integration. Typically, data cleaning and data integration are performed as a pre-processing step when preparing data for data warehouse. Additionally, data cleaning can be performed to detect and remove redundancies that may have resulted from data integration. Now let's discuss data reduction. Data reduction obtains a reduced representation of the data set that is much smaller in volume yet produces the same analytical results. Data reduction strategies include dimensionality reduction as well as numerosity reduction. In dimensionality reduction, data encoding schemes are applied so as to obtain a reduced or compressed representation of the original data. Whereas in numerosity reduction, the data are replaced by alternative and smaller representations using parametric model or non-parametric model. Now let's discuss data transformation. If you would like to use a distance-based mining algorithm for your analysis, such as neural network, nearest neighbor classifier, or clustering, such methods provide better results if the data to be analyzed have been normalized. That is, if the data is scaled to a smaller range such as 0 to 1 or minus 1 to 1. Your customer data, for example, contains the attributes like age and annual salary. The annual salary attribute usually takes much larger values than age. Therefore, if the attributes are left unnormalized, the distance measurement taken on annual salary will generally outweigh distance measurements taken on age. Discretization and concept hierarchy generation can also be useful, where raw data values for attributes are replaced by range or higher conceptual levels. Let's take an example. Raw values for age may be replaced by higher level concepts such as youth, adult, or senior. Discretization and concept hierarchy generation are powerful tools for data mining in that they allow data mining at multiple abstraction levels. Normalization, data discretization, and concept hierarchy generation are forms of the data transformation. In summary, real-world data tends to be dirty, incomplete, and inconsistent. Data pre-processing techniques can improve data quality, and thereby it helps to improve the accuracy as well as efficiency of the subsequent mining process. Data pre-processing is an important step in the knowledge discovery process because quality decisions must be based on quality data. Detecting data anomalies, rectifying them early, and reducing the data to be analyzed can lead to huge payoffs for decision making. So that's it for this lecture. Thank you.